Amid growing public unrest in Greece, the government there is temporarily halting the construction of permanent detention centers for people seeking asylum who are flocking to the country. Tens of thousands of migrants and refugees have been stranded in Greece for more than 4 years since the border with neighboring Macedonia was sealed and the European Union failed to offer enough places to asylum seekers. Special correspondent Malcolm Brabant traveled to the island of Lesbos, a refugee way station, but he begins his report in the Greek capital, Athens.
They traveled from the front line of Europe's migration crisis to show the Greek Interior Ministry that they've had enough. We are all islanders, shouted a protester. In the islands of the Aegean Sea, traditional hospitality has given way to frustration and anger.
Aye.
In the past 5 years, more than 1,150,000 asylum seekers have landed on their beaches. A man called Thodoris Zelekas from the island of Lesbos shouted, "We won't give away our sacred land to non-Christians, to illegal migrants." This is the target of his indignation, Moria in Lesbos, universally vilified as an overcrowded, insanitary, dangerous open prison. Originally designed to hold 2,000 temporary migrants, it has mutated into a permanent ghetto for 20,000, 10 times its intended capacity.
Where are their papers? I have an ID. My name is Thodoris Zelekas. Where are their papers? They are illegal migrants.
His concern, and that of other protesters, is that a bigger migrant camp is due to be built close to the Taxiarchus Monastery, one of the holiest places in Lesbos, where, it's claimed, miracles take place.
Those that come here are raging dogs. They are born to savage any Christian when they see one. But God will send fire like he did in China, in Australia, in Brazil, and other places. God will take care of us, that's certain.
But not everyone holds such extreme views.
I am very angry for both sides, from our island, the Greek people, and from the refugees, because they put a lot of people in one hot spot. The living conditions are terrible. The people that live near the harbors, the villages there, suffer.
Stop incarceration and seizing land, they chant.
They want to leave as much as we want them to leave, because it is ruining our regular daily life there. We're not asking for anything else, we're just asking what they want to do. They want to leave as well.
Kostas Moutsouris, the regional governor of the Northern Aegean, is leading the campaign to relieve the islands.
I really don't think anyone has fallen into the water.
There were 60,000 new arrivals in 2019. It was the busiest year since 2016. Crews from the Irish non-profit Refugee Rescue say that young Afghan men comprise an estimated 70% of those reaching Lesbos from Turkey on flimsy dinghies. But others come from Africa and the Middle East. Immigrants comprise 40% of the population of the five affected islands, whereas on the Greek mainland, the figure is only 2%. Governor Moutsouris says the imbalance needs to be corrected.
All these people have to be dispersed around the country and probably in Europe. But if it's not possible in Europe, to be dispersed in the rest of the country.
And the governor had this warning.
It's like powder waiting a match to start fire.
Governor Moutsouris wants to avoid a repeat of scenes in early February, when migrants clashed with riot police after protesting about conditions inside Moria. The police deployed tough tactics against the predominantly young male protesters. But they were accused of brutality after migrant families with young children were overwhelmed by tear gas. Tensions rose to the surface in January when islanders went on strike and staged demonstrations demanding the closure of the camps. Continuing hostility has forced the migration minister, Notis Mitsotakis, to freeze plans announced earlier this year in the Greek parliament.
The situation is unacceptable. That is why we have been saying for the last 2 months that the new centers have to be built on the islands, with dignified living conditions for those inside, and the utmost security for the region, and the utmost security for the employees of the asylum service, so they can effectively speed up their services.
The government's retreat is a victory for a campaign of civil disobedience on Lesbos, where islanders blocked access roads, leading to land requisitioned by the government for a new detention camp. But protest leader Vespina Gabriel is aware the battle isn't over yet.
There's going to be a war amongst the people, the local people, with the government people. We are not going to allow them to put any campsite, not on this island or nowhere in the northern Aegean. People cannot live. The farmers are suffering as well. And the lives of the people has been just absolutely destroyed. You cannot understand what they're going through.
This is the fishing village of Skala Sikamenia in northern Lesbos. 5 years ago, residents were nominated for the Nobel Peace Prize for saving the lives of so many migrants. But weary of the open borders policy of the previous left-leaning government, the people of Lesbos turned right at the last election 6 months ago. Greece's new conservative government is trying to project a tough image when it comes to migration. It says it's determined to protect the country's frontiers. Recently, it announced plans to build a floating wall between Turkey, 6 miles away in that direction, and this island, Lesbos. The wall is supposed to be 1.7 miles long with lights on at night, and the government hopes that it's going to deter migrants from making the crossing. But the idea of a maritime version of President Trump's Mexican wall has been condemned. Experts believe the construction could further endanger migrants' lives. Grace Lynn Moore from Massachusetts is a volunteer with the Irish nonprofit Refugee Rescue.
I think that there's a poet that said it best, that you don't put your children on a boat unless your home is the jaws of a shark. These people are fleeing war, and the glimpse of hope that is the shores of Europe is oftentimes an overcrowded camp. Policies are enacted by the EU to make their lives more and more difficult here to deter them from coming. But because of the kind of violence that they see and the danger of their home country, they have no other choice.
The Greek government has appealed to NATO to reinforce European Coast Guard vessels patrolling waters used by migrants and people traffickers. But political analyst Nick Malkoutsis believes the Greeks are in denial about the reality of the influx.
There seems to be a lack of desire among Greek politicians and in Greek society to discuss the fact that there are tens of thousands of genuine asylum seekers here in Greece who are not going anywhere. They're not being allowed to go to Northern Europe or other countries that they want to, and they are stuck here for years on end, and Greek society isn't really addressing this issue about how to integrate, how to provide jobs, how to provide education.
Back outside Parliament, the protesters found sympathy from a surprising source. Anwar Bakri, Secretary General of the Syrians Association in Greece.
We do agree with their requests and their demands, the people of the five islands in the Aegean Sea, because what's going on is a crime against humanity in these five islands. Close down these animal farms. Give the papers to the refugees so they can go north, because in Greece the situation is very, very bad.
And it could get worse. Potentially the numbers could be swollen by refugees from heavy fighting in Syria's Idlib province. Not to mention Turkey's President Erdogan's constant threat to open the migration floodgates. The islands and their unhappy guests are fishing for a reversal of European Union policy. But since the rest of Europe effectively sealed off Greece 4 years ago, there has been no sign of the tide changing. So the aspirations of the migrants and islanders are likely to flounder once again. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Malcolm Brabant in Lesbos.